We're here in Barcelona, but we're about to travel to Ibiza, to a racing paradise, hopefully. Eden Games, I'm sorry, is the developer of Test Drive Unlimited 2. And we've seen a lot of this game today. What have you been showing us in this presentation?
We've shown you a good bunch of all the different new features that we've integrated in Test Drive Unlimited 2. We've covered basically the big modifications we did in terms of the car experience. We've completely changed the car dynamics, added vehicle damage. We've also added new all-terrain vehicles for the off-road experience that we've developed. We've also shown you all the new social aspects that we've developed in the game. We've extended the club experience. Now players can, we've improved the online connection so players can meet up and always stay together. To meet players now, it's through your avatar, where you can be able to communicate using animations and, you know, getting information on your friends. We've also, it's really extending the more experience, the massively open online racing experience. We've also added a offline experience in the game, and basically integrated a notion of that it will be a game that will continue to evolve after the release of the game, adding in community management DLC plan.
And of course, this isn't just a racing game, it's a more of a social experience as well. And you've been showing us that you can create different clubs in the game for your avatar. How does that work?
Yes, we've integrated the notion of club in the game. The idea is that players can either meet each other in different meeting points and either challenge each other, but the idea is also to regroup them towards a common goal following the principles of clans or guild like in MMOs. You can either create or be part of a racing club. So when you create your club, for example, you can invite your online friends or other players you met to become club members. And between club members, you can either do challenges just for fun or compete in inter-club challenges with clubs of the same level to earn points and money. With these points and money, you'll be able to make your club progress and earn recognition of your team skills.
And I want to talk a little bit about the cars as well, because you don't start with the most badass, the fastest cars. You unlock those after a while. How long do I have to drive and play to get hold of these really, really good cars?
Well, for us, it's you. We want you to live in this beautiful, luxurious lifestyle. Your objective is to go from rags to riches and show off your success to others. Our objective is to make sure that you can access this after a certain number of hours.
And let's talk about Ibiza that you've been tracking carefully and reproducing in the game. How did you work with that?
Well, yes, we've integrated a completely new island called Ibiza. For us, we wanted a Mediterranean island, a warm, dry area compared to Hawaii, which we've had in the first test drive. And Ibiza, it's about 380 square kilometers. You've got 930 kilometers of roads. You've got deserts, forests, fields, the cities themselves in terms of the architecture. You've got a lot of historical buildings, narrow roads. So it really makes a big difference in terms of Hawaii, the island that we had in the initial test drive, which you will be able to go explore in Test Drive Unlimited 2.
Yeah, okay. That's not a secret. We get to see Hawaii in this game as well.
Definitely. The idea is that you will have Ibiza to start off on, but you will also be able to go back, go and explore Hawaii. And Hawaii, for the fans of the first test drive, we really reworked it so that they can rediscover Hawaii in a new light. We've reworked the graphics so that we've integrated the night cycle and weather conditions. We've also added 600 kilometers of asphalt and off-road network. We've integrated the new game progression. We changed the challenges and the missions to new areas. So basically, they'll be able to rediscover Hawaii differently.
Okay, and finally, do you have a favorite part in this game when you've been trying it out yourself? A moment, perhaps?
Oh, well, what I love is to be, by the fact that we've reworked the car dynamics, now each car has its own personality. Not only we've increased the car rendering, for example, to really get the car as beautiful as possible, because for us a car is like a jewel case, but also each car, in terms of the way you will be driving it, will be fun and credible and will have its own personality when you play it.
So what's your favorite car then?
Ooh, that's a good question. My favorite car is the Ford Mustang. So it's really a muscle car, and it's really fun to drive it. I can do crazy drifts with it, and it's one of the classic cars that I really love.
All right. And when are you shipping Test Drive Unlimited 2?
We're shipping Test Drive Unlimited 2 on PS3, 360, and PC this fall, 2010.
Okay, thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.